Hello, dear students. My name is Shashank Shekhar, Master Teacher of Mathematics at Vedantu. Here we are presenting solutions for KVPY 2018 SX stream, that is class 12. In this video, I have taken question from part 1. Let's see what the question is. The very second question of the paper. On any given arc of positive length on unit circle mod z equal to 1 in the complex plane, okay. Now four options are given. There need not be any root of infinity. There lies exactly one root of infinity. There are more than one but finitely many roots of unity. Option D, there are infinitely many roots of unity. Now what are roots of unity? Let's see how can we observe the correct option, how can we find the correct option. So the roots of unity, considering roots of unity, thinking about roots of unity, the roots of unity means the roots of the equation z raised power n equal to 1. Now 1 can be written as e raised power iota 2k pi cos 2k pi plus iota sin 2k pi. Cos 2k pi is 1 and sin 2k pi is 0. K is some integer. So finally, the roots of unity means z is equal to e raised power iota 2k pi by n, where generally k is taken from 0 to n minus 1. Finally, z is basically 1 e raised power iota 2 pi by n e raised power iota 4 pi by n and so on. These are the roots of unity. Clear? Now on this circle, this is a circle, unit circle, I'm plotting this circle. Okay. Center at origin, radius 1. So on this circle, if some given arc, on any given arc of positive length, suppose I take some this arc here, this arc length is given. On this arc length, now these roots of unity are distributed symmetrically on this circle. Each distance between two consecutive roots, the chord joining two consecutive roots will actually subtends what angle? 2 pi by n at center. Now considering, let the given arc to be L and that arc is making some angle, suppose theta at the center. So here we can say as a radius is 1, r is equal to L is equal to r into theta, r is 1, so it is equal to theta. You can say this implies theta is equal to L as r is equal to 1. Clear? Now if we take suppose 2 pi by n to be smaller than this angle theta, this angle 2 pi by n is smaller than this. In fact, this angle which this arc length subtends at origin and theta is basically L here. That is, I want to say, if you choose n as something greater than 2 pi by L, L is given. So n is anything greater than 2 pi by L, for any n, there will be a root which will lie on the arc. That particular arc taken. So for any n belonging to the interval 2 pi by L to infinity, n is integer, natural number. Okay, so for any n belonging to 2 pi by L to infinity, द रूट ऑफ यूनिटी, दिस रूट विल फॉल ऑन दिस आर्क, पर्टिकुलरली दिस आर्क टेकन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ सपोज एल इज वेरी स्मॉल, सपोज आई एम टेकिंग इट इज एज 0.01 सपोज, ओके, और एनी एल यू कैन टेक 0.001, 0.00001, सो करस्पॉन्ड टू एवरी एल एन. इफ आई टेक एन टू बी मोर देन 200 पाई, दैट इज यू कैन टेक एन ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू 200 पाई मीन्स 3.18 ग्रेटर देन 628, दैट इज 629 टू इन्फिनिटी, यू विल गेट अ रूट ऑफ यूनिटी फॉलिंग ऑन द दैट आर्क, दैट आर्क ऑफ लेंथ 0.001. सो द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन मस्ट बी देर आर इन्फाइनाइटली मेनी वैल्यूज, दैट इज इन्फाइनाइटली many values of n possible. So correspondingly, infinitely many roots of unity will fall. For n equal to 629, the root of unity will fall on this arc taken. For n equal to 630s, for n equal to 631, corresponding to the arc length given to be 0.01. Similarly, for any given arc length, there would be infinitely many values of n, corresponding to which the roots of unity will fall upon this taken arc. So, the answer to this question must be, there must be infinitely many roots of unity. See, the roots of unity are basically symmetrically distributed on this circle. So if you take any arc, we can increase n correspondingly. So for any arc length, given arc length L, we have to take n greater than 2 pi by L, any n in the falling in the interval 2 pi by L to infinity. So infinitely many values of n and corresponding infinitely many roots of unity will fall upon that. I hope you understood the solution, and thank you for watching. Stay tuned for the next question. Thank you.